urgent, Representative Jim Jordan issues dire warning to lukewarm establishment. This is big. Representative Jim Jordan of Ohio in the House Freedom Caucus has an ominous message for rhinos who have not kept their word to the voters: the end is near. The establishment have been using conservative voters like a booty call. They come around and try to nail your vote, but when the exhilaration of the election ends, they never call until the next time they need their vote. In 2008 and 2012, massive amounts of these voters stayed home. It took Donald Trump to bring them back to the polls, and the establishment hates Trump because he won't be controlled. Voters stay home because when there is a choice of a liberal or an establishment candidate, they see it as a lose-lose situation, so why bother to vote? We have to be very careful. There are a lot of establishment Republicans who wish to remain in the Senate that leads to that dreaded disease gonorrhea lectum, and the only drug it is not resistant to is Votimit. Don't wait. Get inoculated as soon as you can. The dynamic conservative connects the dots of recent political shock waves to warn those in the public square. From the uprising of the Tea Party movement in 2010, to Dave Brat defeating House Majority Whip Eric Cantor in a primary, to the formation of the Freedom Caucus as a new center of gravity in the House, to John Boehner's early dethroning, and then the 2016 upset by President Donald Trump, the American people have a message for elites in Washington. If that's not sending a message to the establishment in this town, I don't know what will, Jordan says in this exclusive interview. Maybe we ought to do what the American people sent us here to do. When the Republicans had just the House, they told voters that without owning the Senate, they cannot accomplish anything. They then were handed the Senate, and then they told the voters that without the White House, they were helpless. They got the White House and still they cannot get the job done, mostly because they are more interested in stopping Trump than serving the people who voted for them. If Trump wants it, John McCain will block it if he can. Some people consider John McCain a hero. He is anything but. Some have wondered if McCain would switch parties, but I assure you he won't. He doesn't even like the Republican Party. The fly in the ointment could be that, even with the influx of real conservatives, that they could prevent McConnell from remaining as majority leader, but may not have enough support to install one of their own, and thus a compromise candidate would be needed. That compromise candidate would be a PT closer to McConnell than Mike Lee. From the Daily Caller. With Thanksgiving and tax reform nearly behind Congress, the must-pass year-end spending deal by a Republican Congress with a Republican president should make voters cheer. But instead, Jordan fears that Republican leaders are afraid to stand firm for what they campaigned. Jordan lays out the 9 lies of Obamacare. You like your plan, keep your plan. You like your doctor, keep your doctor. Your premiums will decline. Premiums will go down an average of $2,500. Deductibles will go down. The government website will work. The website was secure. Emergency room visits will decline. The 24 cooperatives will work. Remember, when the 2018 elections roll around, you must make sure you vote even if your candidate looks like a sure winner. Make the margins as large as possible to scare the remaining establishment senators into doing their job.